Welcome to Piscina Scandone in Naples for what is going to be a very exciting third session of finals in swimming at the 30th Summer Universiade here in Naples. This is the lineup, the eight who will contest the opening event on night three of finals, the men's 1500 meters freestyle. They have the whistle, the call to the blocks to get ready. It's the longest race on the calendar. It's the men's 1500 meters. They've gone through 25 meters of the 1500. They have to compete. Some people look at this and say, why would you put your body through this? And others say, well, why not? What a great challenge, as we see the first turn, and there's an indication, Yoshida, so Japan, Spain, and the USA turning first, second, and third. It's a lovely shot to be able to just compare the styles. There's not much that differs, really. Some you'll see have slightly higher elbows, others reaching forward with the low arm above the water. Out in the far side, still 6 and 7, and Norman of the USA in lane three. So Escrits Manosa of Spain, Yoshida from Japan, and Norman. They're really just warming into it at the moment. But still, you notice a little upsurge in arm rotation as they come to the wall, just to make sure that they're not caught by surprise, and also to make sure that their turn is effective. Nobody wanting to lose contact with this group, even at this stage. So we come up to the 200. Now the world record split there is 154.31. You can see they're a long way back from that. But that was an extraordinary swim by Sun Yang of China at the Olympic Games in 2012. We see Yoshida just slipping back from the Spaniard in lane six, and also Norman back here in lane three. Norman out of University of California, Berkeley, Cal Berkeley. He went into this with a time of 15 minutes 14.81. Both the athletes we could see underwater then, just breathing to one side. Every now and then they'll have a wee look around, but they get into that habit. Some of them just prefer to breathe one side, and they're happy with that. Good shot of the turn from Norman. Very efficient technician. Keeps swimming right in the center of his lane. Now you see the yellow cap of Johansson in lane four. He had the fastest qualifying time of 15.07. He's out of Southern California. That's his university. He's, of course, a Swede. So Norman's into a really good rhythm now. Johansson on one side, in the center, Norman on in lane three. Just little bits of movement. You can just notice how Yoshida, who was prominent early on, up in the second from the top lane, has now dropped back to, what, fifth place. Norman stays there. Johansson's made his little move, not wanting the American to get too far ahead. Cipinti of Italy is also there. He's swimming in lane five, so he's almost up alongside Johansson. So Norman comes to the wall now. 500 meters. And Norman, Johansson, Escrits Manosa of Spain, and then it would be Cipinti of Italy. So one, two, three, and four. The Australian swimmers are in lanes one and eight, with Josh Parrish in lane one. It's right down at the bottom of our pool. We'll see him a moment, just out of shot there. And in lane eight, Ben Roberts, and two young swimmers who battled out the Australian title, which Parrish won earlier this year. Of course, Australia had an extraordinary record in Olympic 1500 meters in particular, and I recall feeling very proud to have been calling the race in 1996 at the Olympic Games in Atlanta when Kieran Perkins won. Kieran Perkins set world records, taking the time down by 7 minutes over a period of 2 years. But at that race in Atlanta, he only just qualified for the final, 0.02 seconds ahead of the next swimmer, the ninth swimmer. And everyone believed that he was finished. He had no show, and he swam from lane eight, and that's why I talk about lane eight in a race like this. In lane eight, he swam, and he was absolutely fantastic. It was a great example of determination and courage and almost battling against the odds. So from way out in lane eight, Kieran Perkins swam to his second consecutive Olympic gold medal, having won in 1992 when he set a world record. And an everlasting memory was to see Perkins at the end try and get out of the pool. And if ever a man was absolutely exhausted, it was Perkins on that particular day. He sat on the edge of the pool and looked like he'd turned into a big ball of jelly. He was absolutely, he'd given it everything. Fifth place, it looks like Matteo Lamberti is followed by Yoshida, and then Parrish and Roberts. Coming up to the 1,000. Just keep an eye on this turn, because at the last one we saw Norman really just be powerfully off the wall and pick up a little bit on Johansson. Not this time. See the upbeat of the kick from Johansson out of the turn. A little surge now. Those arms will be aching, the body will be aching, the lungs. All the training is required to make sure you get through the painful periods of this particular race. Johansson turns, still in front. Norman and Cipinti. The Italian surely will respond to the crowd. Very smooth, nice turn again from Johansson. He's in the groove, kicks away. Others, there are three of them staying with him. There's the crowd roar for the Italian. At every turn, Johansson slightly extending that lead. It's 2:31, 2.31 seconds. We'll see what the lead is at the 1200. So he's just surging with every turn, but he knows there's still a way to go. Has one of these pursuing swimmers got enough in the tank to attack Johansson on the way home? The Swede looks totally in control. He added an extra tenth of a second onto his lead. It's a classy swim at the moment, Victor Johansson of Sweden. Just three lengths of the pool now to go. Once they turn here, bang, and off the wall goes Victor Johansson, representing Sweden. His university is that of Southern California. He swum absolutely to perfection here. Still plenty of drive, big splash with the feet, powerful out of the turn again. Keeping it well together. Look at the kick on him. Upping the tempo. He'll hear the crowd as well. Wow, he's moving away further. This is a great finish from Victor Johansson. Powerful leg drive off the wall, zips past the opposition. He's got plenty in the tank for a final sprint. The roar comes up too, not just for Johansson, but in the battle for second and third. 1500 meters has been swum almost, and the Swede Victor Johansson has led for most of that race. And it's been a dominant swim by the Swede. And a popular silver medal for Italy. And the USA take the bronze medal. The first final of night three of competition. The men's 1500 meters. And that is the official story. Sweden, Italy, USA.